chart drawn in a North Indian style. Now divide this chart into two halves from the ascendant to the seventh house. So one part is from the first house to the sixth house. The other part is to the seventh house up till 12th, right? Now, while dividing this, what am I trying to tell you? There are two kind of horoscope which we prominently see, and then there is a third variation which is not very commonly seen. So I'm going to talk about these three variations. The first one is the Bhog Yoni chart, the chart which is clearly indicating that the person, the native, is here to reap whatever he has gathered in his previous lives, whether it is good or bad. His chart and his life will be completely driven by the Bhog factor. Bhog is a word of Hindi which means to consume. So he is here just to consume. And to consume what? The fruits of his previous life. Now, while saying this, I'm suggesting that a horoscope which is falling in the Bhog Yoni category is a horoscope which tells you that there is very little chance of making much changes in the life pattern of this native by the way of what kind of decision he makes, what kind of actions he do in his life.
Now let's understand the motivation of a person. What drives the person? What is the reason of certain events which are taking place in a person's life by the way of an example? The technique which I am telling you is, take up a horoscope which you want to analyze and understand if that horoscope is a fruit gathering horoscope, that is the Bhogi horoscope, or the person is Karma Yoni and having a Karma Yoni horoscope. So divide the chart from this point into two halves. Okay. From 15 degree, 30 degree of ascendant, you'll take second house, third house, fourth, fifth, sixth, and 180 degree to 195 degree of seventh house should be taken in Bhog Yoni. So if all the major planets in a chart are concentrated in this part, that is from the ascendant to the sixth house and this part of the seventh house, it is a Bhoga Yoni. Now what do you mean by Bhoga Yoni? People taking birth with these kind of chart are people who are here to deplete their previous karmas to a great extent. They are the ones who must bear the result of past karma flow through life until they finally receive the opportunity which allow them to create the future. Talking the astrological terms, those who have planet below the horizon, that is between the ascendant and the seventh house, have incarnated primarily just to reap their previous life karmas. These are the people who are not necessarily, get good or bad result, but they will get whatever is destined. They can also have a comfortable and pleasant life and otherwise also, but that will majorly depend on their previous karmas and not on what kind of action, what kind of decision, what kind of initiatives they take in this life. The major say in their life will be of destiny. They will have a life like merely being a pawn in the hands of destiny. On the other hand, if all the concentration of the planet or majorly a planet are sitting from 7th house to the ascendant, this kind of a chart belongs to karma yoni. So when planets are sitting in these degree in the 7th house, 8th house, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th and 0 to 15 degree in the ascendant, these people are heavily driven by the karma, by the actions they take in the current life. They will instantly get the result of whatever kind of decision they are making. All right. They will confront situation where their decision and action give a new and momentous direction to the soul's journey with planets in these part of the chart makes a person action oriented. These are the people who believe in action, and also their action will instantly give them result, good or bad. Now here comes the theory that we generally hear from people, that some people are doing utterly bad karmas in their life, but still they are happy and enjoying every kind of luxury because they have bhoga yoni. They are not reaping the karma which they are doing in the current life. Rather, they are reaping the karma which they have done in previous life to a great extent. Whereas we see people who do little effort and get major breakthrough results because they have planet in 7th to ascendant, making them karma yoni charts. So this is the difference. Now let's understand further. Let's take a look at the different houses which belong to bhogi yonis. Now, as I told you that ascendant can be divided into two portions, one above the horizon, the other below. The former represent individual's possibility to generate newer karmas. All right. While the latter, the other one, are already bringing lot of karma to deplete. The first house represents the essence of his life force, which is here to evolve. They have the potential, and upon careful use of which, their future will be very much dependent. Okay, now the second house. What does the second house denote? Second to sixth inclusive signifies those aspect of life which the individual has no control on. It might look like that we have a lot of control on these portion of our life, but actually if you do a microscopic analysis, you'll understand that this is not the case. Second house is all about creative potential, sensitivity, your eyesight, your vision, your power to foresight, your speech, family relations, your accumulated assets or assets which you receive from the family. None of these is subject to the will of the person concerned. The auspicious or inauspicious condition related to these houses must simply be accepted. Okay? The third house shows impediments, injuries, short journeys, year, any planet affecting this house increase or reduce the possibility of receiving opportunities. See, opportunities cannot be created. They come your way. Taking them up or leaving them is your choice. But in this case, in the case of Bhoga Yonis, whether they catch the opportunity or let it go, still the result will depend on whatever they are carrying from the past lives. Whatever kind of effort they put in. Look, in the same class, there are two kind of people who do wonderful with little effort, and others are also who put in day in and day night of effort, still receive results which are not expected by them. Or the vice versa can also be true. These people can also be the one who put in little effort and get all the good results in their life. All right. But whatever I'm trying to convey is that these planet, if concentrated in these house, makes a person utterly dependent on the destiny. Their own decision or mindfulness will not gradually help them. So they should accept incidents happening in their life as a parcel of the destiny, and they should be happy about it that they are actually depleting some karmas. Whereas these are the person with new souls, and they are here to make newer karmas. Okay? Now the third house, as I said, is concerned to all these things. But their goals and directions are not offered by this house. Opportunity can come from this house, but not the direction. For direction, you should look at the ninth house. All right. Brothers, friends, and relatives are signified by this house. But they are blood relations, your brothers, etc. And you don't have any control on these things. Mercury may give here a good result, but Saturn can restrict this opportunity giving house in your life. None of these attributes by themselves activate the individual in any definite way. All are mere capabilities, you know, by which they do or not do anything. They lack a specific direction. They just come on their own and give you results. One may receive them or may not. That is all about destiny. You can receive good opportunities. You can be at the right place on the right time. But that has to be a chance of destiny. Now let's take the fourth house. It represents the home, mother, property, heart, intelligence, false allegations. All of these may upset the individual. They can disturb his mental composure and peace of mind. But these factors will go to build up his emotional and mental constitution. The individual will have to accept these conditions and can hope to alter them only marginally in a very small form. One cannot change one's mother. You cannot change the fact that you are born from a particular womb, however hard you may try. Such is the situation of Bhoga Yoni souls. Even the fifth and the sixth house, which are important in deciding the future, fortune, and how much comfort and ease a person will have in their life, also produces conditions which an individual have no control on. Any planetary activation on these houses indicates the environment in which the individual must survive and the favorable or adverse circumstances under which he must carry out his life's journey. Now, the fifth house, what does it indicate? As I suppose all of us know that the fifth house indicates offspring, your children, technical and general intelligence, psychic faculties, artistic talents, love affairs, and all kind of virtues which are done by your father, ethics, recreation, and so on. Entertainment is also denoted by the fifth house. All right. You can even say entertainment industry, etc. Okay. Now, while after listening to me, you can say, oh no, this house denotes a lot of freedom, as you can use creative intelligence, use your artistic talent. But listen and try to understand that in fact, the house does not signify the utilization of these, talents. You can possess a talent, but to utilize it, you have to be very action oriented. And this house gives you the talent, but to utilize this, you need this house. Okay, so if again I am reiterating that concentration of planet in these houses make the soul a bhoga yoni. Until and unless there is a balance. All right, if there is a balance of planet in both the spheres, then he can lead a balanced life. Otherwise, it will, majorly concentrate to a particular area, either of the two. Now, this house also denotes love affair, intelligence, and morality. In the fifth house, situations are imposed on the individual from which he cannot always, pull himself out. Now, in the sixth house, the malefics are expected to give a good result. We all know them. But this rule is liable to some kind of misunderstanding. There is a misunderstanding in analyzing this rule that the malefic planet in sixth house gives good result. From this house, prediction can be made regarding the physical, mental suffering, enemies, theft, litigation, fear of death, ill health, and how a person serves. No one really wants these aspects of life to flourish. Okay, to have a malefic planet here, it simply assures that you will have these conditions in your life. You will have enemies, you will have diseases from which you will come out, you will have enemies from which you will come out. All right, so they assure the negative along with that you have the courage of coming out from them. If some planetary influence restrict their development and increase, it is considered helpful. The sixth is a very mysterious house whose result come to the surface from some other level of the soul, which you have accumulated from ages. Such karmic issues arise from a special reason which cannot be avoided. When malefic influence this house, as let's say Mars, Sun, Rahu, posited here, they cause expansion of this house. For this reason, the malefic are considered desirable here. However, you can say this does not nullify the fact that the individual is helpless to do anything to mitigate or to reduce the effect of this house. But he will have only one choice, to bear it courageously and to maintain his or her dignity even through the testing time. And then, after all the karmic things are depleted from this house, he will evolve as a newer and a better person. But you know, no one wants to fall in a pit just to prove that he can climb out of a pit. It is always better to avoid a pit. But the sixth house, if a planet is here, it makes sure, the destiny makes sure that you first enter a tiff and then show courage and come out of it. Even it is said that if the ninth lord is sitting in the sixth house, a person can only have luck when he pushes himself into, you know, fights and matter of litigation, or just go ahead and invite problems. Then only he can attain luck or activate the house of luck. And I've seen it coming true in many cases. All right, let's not digress and move further. So this is all about these houses which depict Bhogayoni. Now, individual freedom becomes a possibility in the seventh house if the planet is lying in these degrees. From this point onward, the karmic influence operate on individuals by the way of free will. Now, these karma yoni souls have lot of free will. You might not actually see it right now, but in perspective, in retrospect, you'll understand that people who had planet in these houses actually made out something of their life by the actions they took, by the decisions they took. Take out horoscope of any influential people, you'll understand that major concentration of planets were in these houses. The big planets were situated in these houses, and they were throughout our karma yoni soul. The seventh house signifies marriage, sexual relations, partnerships, business, trade and commerce, functioning diseases of the genitals, death, pride, status in life, and many more factors which are signified by the seventh house. The individual is also exposed to conditions which produce in his mind the urge to do something about them. At this stage, conditions arise which may induce a person to enforce energy to yield results. This is the house where a person starts putting his efforts to obtain a result. It is important to note that at the junction of night and day, psychic forces fill the horizon. Dawn and dusk are the moments of great spiritual power, as we all know, the Brahma Muhurat and the Sandhya Vela, which is known in Hindi. Individual must be very alert in order to ward off the adverse influences which comes with a high consciousness. Alright, so planet in seventh house, especially the portion in which it is above the horizon, you know, opens a possibility to exercise free will. So that's why relations which are made here can be broken off by the way of divorce, etc., by terminating of partnerships. Do you understand how the play is coming out now? How the karma yoni soul is operating now? It is so clear. All right. The possibility of independent action becomes pronounced in the eighth house. From this house, there are two currents which are flowing in the individual now. At one hand, they have certain forces of the previous houses as well, and they have to bore the changes whichever are coming to the previous house in the 8th house. That is where the transformation happens. Here the individual may be led to take action of some kind which will influence the future condition. Now the future is the 9th house. He generates fresh condition which will reach fructification in times to come. In times to come, these are the houses which are the which depicts the future. Here the journey restarts. All right. The 8th house, as we all know, influences longevity, secret diseases, legacies, secret pleasures. The place and nature of death also can be seen from the 8th house. These condition also includes scandal, secrets, enemies, some kind of undiagnosed diseases, and also fruits of past actions. All right. The individual will have very little control over them, but these factors exist along with others also, on which the individual will have full control. Actions connected with the 8th house are a preparation for the initiation process which will happen in the 9th house. All right. So this is how we explain. Now the 9th house forms the part of the spiritual triangle. Now what do you understand by the spiritual triangle? This is known as the spiritual triangle. 9th house is the part of it. It involves individual in action, not merely in gathering of result of his karma. Under the influence of the 9th house, the individual will receive those results of past karma which are made available to him so that he may evolve or involve himself in new spiritual activities. So there will be a helping platform in the 9th house. The past karma which come through the 9th house will serve you as a helping platform to increase your spirituality. This house is related to gods from whom we receive benedictions surrounding us. The spiritual atmosphere which we dwell in is seen from the 9th house. The philosophical attitude which comes to an individual, long travel, grace in personality, is seen from the 9th house. If the 9th lord is exalted, if you have a very benefic planet or a luminary in the 9th house, you will see that this person will execute great grace. He's a very graceful person. He or she is a very graceful person. It provides a very beautiful condition to initiate meditation and mantra. Beginning of a new career and effort towards realization is also seen from the 9th house. 9th house generates cause which may have a long results throughout your life. Action which you take here in the 9th house can change your life on a transformational level. The forces of these houses, like the 9th house, is very auspicious. They generally yield auspicious result. Even the effect of malefic like Sun, Mars, Saturn, or a waning moon or nodes will be greatly significant in changing one attitude, capability, condition if they are placed in the 9th house. The 10th house is concerned with the matter of one's involvement in the outside world. Now, here starts in the 10th house, the worldly matters also starts. It is generally regarded as the house of profession and livelihood, karma, honor, respect from the society. As far as these factors are concerned, one has little control, but others aspect of This house energizes the individual's life so that his potentials come out in full force. You know, you do a good karma, you do a good deed, or you take a great action in your career. If you have a planet in 10th house, you will see the result instantly. Good or bad, whatever. Here you will come in contact with different persons, circumstances which will contribute in important factors in your life. In this sense, the 10th house signifies involvement in social activities, accomplishment of certain level, whatever you learn. Your counseling also comes from these two houses. The way you command in the society comes from the 10th house. Alright. Now this is what all is related to the 10th house. Here the person starts taking up action. If the concentration of planets happens from 7 to the 12th house, the person is totally self-motivated. He cannot blame or, give total credit to the destiny for whatever is happening in his life, because everything depends on his karma, on his actions. He will yield result of his actions instantly. So that is how we decide. Now let's see, the 11th house is a very popular house, an important base of triangle of materiality. As we all know, this is the triangle for materialism, and 11th house being the most important one. It is the house of gains, income, friendship, wealth, and many other things begin in this house. There are some aspects of life which are greatly valued by men and are totally involving materialistic gains. The presence of planet here shows the desire in a human being. Such planets are treated as profitable in a worldly sense only. They cannot help you on a spiritual level, but they can help you to achieve all the worldly pleasures. It is also said, if we do not have planet in the 10th and 11th house, you are not meant to earn or to make your life on your own. Alright? But there are other factors also, the dasha, antardasha and everything, transits as well. So transits are the chance given to us to become a karma yoni, bhoga yoni, or the both. Okay, so transits are very important. Transits can make you can lend a chance in your fate to become action oriented. All right, so we should utilize the period of transit to a great extent. Now, coming back to the topic, so that is all about which I talked regarding the 11th house. Now the 12th house represents the region of the sky which planet enters shortly after rising on the eastern horizon. It is one of the house which is having several layers and several meaning. The disposition of this house may relate to incarnation of the soul, to the eternal past, the moral quotient in a person's life. It also represents the end of journey, life after death, pleasure of bed, imprisonment, and all kinds of things which are going out, the expenditure. All right, the control of the individual over many of these things and these aspects of life is completely absent if they do not have planet in karma yoni path. Okay, to sum up now, the planets above the horizon will energize those aspects of life which has much freedom of action. Action is vital for changing the course of the individual's involvement with the world at large, turning him outward to attain his ultimate destiny. Planet in the involutionary portion of the horoscope represent the houses below the horizon will be able to provide pleasant condition and a luxurious life, but they relate primarily to the present one, the present life. Their influence will not generate fresh forces, fresh karmas, which affect the future life of the individual. He has to bear them whether they are pleasant or adverse. Planets in the above the horizon create forces which have far-reaching karmic consequences. All right. So that is one rule of how I decode a horoscope. I know I have created a mess in this chart, but please bear with me. I was going with the flow, and I hope this made sense. And now this can, if you decode your chart this way, it can be really helpful of, you know, which planet to treat. Like I've given you a hint, the planets which are sitting in 15 to 30 degree will be coming in the Bhoga Yoni, whereas planet sitting in 0 to 15 degree will come in the Karma Yoni. Now this can be, now these are the layers which are attached in a particular technique. All right. That how to decode it on the planetary level. Now the first step we have done, we have decoded in on the basis of the 12 houses. Now let's go to planetary level and divide the planets into these sections and then understand. Then this can also help us in decoding the dasha of a planet. That in this dasha, do we take up actions and start working on our instinct, or let us sit quietly and wait for the right moment? This is very important. Taking action at the right time during the dasha and the dasha of the right planet. I know we cannot sit for 20 years, but we can wait for a correct antardasha to start, pratyantardasha to start. All right, which will help our actions. So this is how we start decoding the planets, the dasha, even transits. Okay. So that is all from my side. Hope you understood this technique. Hope you see some charts. Like for instance, if I have to tell you, let's say, Dhirubhai Ambani's chart, the most favorite of all. Now see, all the planet majorly are in the Karma Yoni part. So you cannot say that he had a fluke of luck and rose to fame. Now let's see in Princess Diana chart. Let's say I have to decode her 7th house. So she has moon at 26 degree, the 7th lot. I'm just telling you. I'm not drawing the chart or showing it to you, but I'm telling that Princess Diana's 7th lord is moon, which is at 26 degree. It falls in the Bhoga Yoni. So she had to go through everything because it was destined for her. It was her life to deplete the karma, not to create new ones. All right. So this is how we decode each house, each planet, and the horoscope in total. This is the master technique, and I'm enjoying applying it to several charts and see the results beautifully. So I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks a lot. Have a good day.